My name is Tom Pidley. I'm the guy who, for the last two autumns, collected the jewel stamps that allowed us to collect an incredible amount of dishware and pots and pans that we then included in the following spring's Easter baskets. It was kind of a spur-of-the-moment idea that turned into a nice little project to help the hungry. While talking to the woman at DuPage Township, hearing her tell how delighted people were to get something extra in their Easter baskets really made the project worthwhile. Making all the stamp collecting, putting them in the sticker books, redeeming the items at Jewel, and then at Easter time, 900 trips up the stairs to bring the items from my basement to the car. And then, of course, the 15 minutes to rearrange the car because I didn't play enough space the first time. Hearing of their happiness definitely brought a smile to my face. Thank you to all of you for all of your help by bringing in your stamps. If Jewel does again this fall or another time, I'll do it again. Thanks in advance for your help. That's 4 months of the year of me being Christ in motion. But for 12 months of the year, I'd like to think I'm Christ in motion by attempting to be a good listener, which allows me to be a better person. This is a little bit of a roundabout story, but stick with me and we'll get there. I work in the office of a moving company. I'm the billing manager, which means I pay our drivers and helpers for the jobs they do every day. I frequently email a woman who does a similar job at an agent in Delaware. We can call her Sue, but her name actually is Sue. And I'm sure she'd be proud to know of her name being used in such a story. Besides the usual work stuff, frequently we'll add a comment about something fun, such as fun weekend plans, how our baseball teams are doing and whatnot. In such emails over the years, Sue has inadvertently given me some good wisdom on how much she loves her husband and how and enjoys spending simple time with him. I really wish I still had the email she sent that cracked the ice surrounding my skull, as it would make the story a whole lot better. But one day she sent me some email telling me something along the lines of how happy and lucky she is to have her guy. Immediately the light bulb in my head turned on that I have a similar situation. I am lucky to have a great gal of my own, but I'm doing it all wrong. Julie and I have been happily married for over nine years, but we often do the things that I want to do or eat the places I want to eat, things like that. And she's okay with that. I usually make sure her likes and dislikes are considered too, but in all honesty, we end up doing what I want to do. Well, I realize that's kind of ridiculous. We need to do things that she wants to do too. She is it for all 50% of our marriage. So in the last year or two, I've really made a conscious effort to listen to the things that she wants to do too, and listen to the things that she is interested in, and make sure that we're doing those things as well. I've really become a better identifier of things that make me say, the way she's talking about this, it's important to her, so let's make it happen. And that has made her happier, and subsequently made me happier by making her happy. By doing all this listening and paying attention better, I've been able to notice the great things Julie does in her daily life, whether for me or for others. She truly is a great person who puts others first. And as the saying goes, attitudes are contagious. Is yours worth catching? Observing her doing things for others has made me want to do the same, both for her and for other people. I have learned to listen and be more patient with others, observing better what is important, and allowing me to be a better person, whether it's at home, at work, or just out and about. So, how is all this listening and being a better husband / better person working out? Well, that's a work in progress. Some days I hit a home run and hear things like, wow, the old team would have never done that. Other days I strike out, letting an opportunity slip by, but I figure that's okay because I'm trying. Rome wasn't built in a day. We are imperfect people in an imperfect world. Yet I believe Christ is in motion through my imperfect attempts to serve others by using the gift of listening. I know that Christ is working in me to try to make me a better person. All I have to do is listen for a change.